who did talk to Leah? Self-determination. And by that, it sits on four codes. And one is to define ourselves. Because for too many years, we've been defined by other people. Now we know that African people, we are the first modern humans. We are, they call us in our scientific name, Homo sapiens sapiens. We're the first modern humans. And as that African walked to the seven continents, he evolved into the different types of people. We are the first Chinese, we are the first Japanese, we are the first Asian people, we are the first Caucasian people. And we call those people the Grimaldi. From their skeletons we found in the caves in Grimaldi, France. They're just like a light-skinned African. You know, with no melanin in their skin. So now we've got this information. Now we say, once we get the information, now we should know better. See, when we know better, we should do better. Okay. But some of us have got intellectually lazy. We got the information presented, and we're going to do anything with it. But self-determination is the way to go. We got to define ourselves because, look, as African people, we are the first human beings to utter a word, a sound. We're the first human beings to write. We're the first human beings to create mathematics and science. Egyptian history is just one of our pinnacles of our greatness that we should study and emulate. The first medical doctor, his name is Imhotep. I-M-H-O-T-E-P. And I hope you will look it up on the internet. And when we talk about medical people, that obviously go way back. But our kids have to know it. And we cannot be talking about what's happening in the 1600s when we were enslaved. We have to talk about the beginning. We are the first people on this planet. See, we have to be brave enough to emulate that. You see, and to speak it and let everyone know. And our kids will, I'm telling you, when I go to the schools and when I tell the little kids about our history and our beginning, you know, before slavery, our origin, the chest swell up with pride. So you mean to tell me we created mathematics before Pythagoras? I say yes. Pythagoras spent 20 years on the banks of the Nile River with the great African of ancient Egypt, Akhenaten, studying mathematics, knowing how to draw a circle. Our kids should be scoring 1,800 on the SAT. No problem. Once we get the information, but as scholars and people of knowledge who know this, we have to insist that they know this information. And one of my jobs is to expose the people. So, yes, I'm in budget with